हेलो हेलो माइक टेस्ट। इफ आई चेंज इट से SMA, वी गेट द SMA ग्राफ ऑटोमेटिकली। वी वैप इट इज ऑल्सो हियर एंड अरून ADX इज हियर। द बी बैंड्स विच इज बोलिंजर बैंड्स इज ऑल्सो हियर। सो विच एक्चुअली यू कैन जस्ट गो एंड सेलेक्ट दिस पर्टिकुलर एरिया एंड यू कैन सी the entire analysis of this particular region. Hello financial programmers, I'm Ritvik Dashora and I'm back with a new video and some new learnings. If you're interested to build a technical analysis dashboard on Streamlit using Python, then you're at the right place. In this video, I will refer to the work that I have done in the past videos in this playlist on Streamlit. We have created, if you remember, we have created multiple tabs of different analysis like pricing data, fundamental data, stock news, open AI, chat GPT. Yes, guys, I've done that thing as well. And the last one would be technical analysis. I'll just go through the entire script very quickly such that you have a proper understanding of what I've done in the past. I would love if you refer to all the past videos as well, but in this video we'll be just focusing on the technical analysis dashboard. If you're new to my YouTube channel, on this channel I turn all my viewers to successful financial programmers. Here I upload videos related to trading bots, implementation of AI in finance, some highly valuable finance APIs, etc., etc. So if you are interested in my work, then you should subscribe to my YouTube channel and also click on the bell icon. There are a lot of things that I'm planning actually. And also quick shout out to my Patreon members. Thank you so much guys. I really appreciate your support and I hope that the service that I'm providing over there is worth each and every penny. For my new viewers, just stay tuned to this video and I'll tell you what is Patreon service that I provide. So let's start. The topics that we are going to cover today are actually I'll talk about the last four videos, not three videos, actually four videos on Streamlit that I have created. I have started this playlist from as simple as installation of Streamlit, which is sometimes very, very difficult because we have to create some environment variables and use VS Code. Then I talked about some basics of Streamlit. And then the third video was a very, very important video was that is on building a simple stock dashboard, which we continued in the fourth video where we incorporated ChatGPT OpenAI platform. And thank you so much guys for giving a great response on that video. And in that video, actually we connected with ChatGPT directly and asked some questions on the reasons why we should buy MSFT, the reasons why we should sell MSFT and the SWOT analysis of MSFT. That's the last video in this playlist. In this video, what I'll do is I'll refer to the library called Pandas TA and how to use it. And then we'll extract an entire list of all major technical indicators. I'll give an option on the Streamlit dashboard on of selecting any particular technical indicator for the analysis. We'll extract the data of the technical indicators. We'll plot it with, I would say, against the close price. And in the end, we'll also extract the technical indicator data adjacent to the close price to do some further analysis. So guys, this was the code that we built in the last three, four videos. So we have extracted Streamlit, Pandas, imported Streamlit, Pandas, NumPy, YFinance, and Plotly. And you can see that the basic, I would say, implementation of Streamlit library that is putting a title, sidebar, inputs of ticker, start date, and end date. We used YFinance, which is actually a Python wrapper for Yahoo Finance, in order to extract the pricing details of any particular ticker, for example, MSFT. We plotted the adjacent close price on Streamlit, and then if you remember, I created four different tabs where we did different analysis for different things. Pricing data, for fundamental data we referred to Alpha Vantage, for stock news data we referred to Stock News API, and then in the end, the last but not the least, which is ChatGPT, we use PyChatGPT library. Now in this case, I'll create another tab which will be of technical indicators, and then we'll just work on that particular tab. So let me just do one thing, Control C, and let's open a new file. It will be a Python file, and then Control V. So I'm just actually referring to the entire code that I have built in the last video. Now, actually, I don't want to have the OpenAI this thing because this would take some time to run. So I'll just write here OpenAI. So actually, I'm just writing OpenAI over there. So I'm not doing any analysis here. I'll comment this as well, and let's just comment this one as well, and just write here say st dot write stock news or news. Let's do the same thing for fundamentals as well, because in this video we are just doing technical analysis. So and then let's just write here fundamental data. Let's keep the pricing pricing data as it is, and that's it. I'll include another tab, but yeah, before that, let's run this code. We need to save it first. Okay, so Control S. Let me just save it as techindicator.py. Now let's run it. Perfect. Yeah, here in the bottom, I'll just write streamlit run and then techindicator.py. This should redirect me to the Google Chrome. Yeah. So you can see this. So this is the stock dashboard we have. Let me just write, say MSFT. Start date is 1 year back, somewhere in January 2022. So yeah, we have got all these things. We have got the chart of MSFT using YFinance. Price movements, the pricing data, if you see all the information is here that we have already coded in the last video. For fundamental data, it's just the text fundamental data. Same for the news and open AI chat GPT as well, because I've actually commented all the lines and I've just provided some text over there. Now let's include another tab. So I'll just go here in the tabs. I'll just provide another one, which is tech indicator. The title of this would be technical analysis dashboard. Control S. Let's go here, rerun. We should have another tab here with us, which is here, technical analysis dashboard. Perfect. Now here with tech indicator st dot subheader technical anal dashboard, right? Control S. Let's rerun this, and we have got this one. Now the main idea here is to get the technical indicators data and then plot it with close, the adjusted close price. In order to get the technical indicator data, we'll use the library called Pandas TA. If you would like to know about Pandas TA library in much detail, then you should watch my full-fledged video on Pandas TA that I recorded I think a year back. So I covered almost all functionality of Pandas TA library, and it would be very helpful for you guys to go through it. But in this video, I'll just pick the most important aspects of Pandas TA library, extract the pricing, or I would say the technical indicators information here, and then just plot it here on the Streamlit dashboard. So let's start with the data frame. DF is equal to PD dot data frame. This is the main data frame that we'll be referring to. Now, indicator list is equal to df dot TA. We'll have to import pandas TA as TA. Now, df dot TA dot indicators as list is equal to true. Now let's just write st dot write in list. Control S. Let's go here and run it. We should get the entire list of all indicators that we have. So yeah, so we have in the top 100, we have all these indicators. I can see B bands, ADX, etc. And if we go here, then there are 100 to 143 as well. So there are total 143 technical indicators that we can actually use here. All these indicators should be in a drop down, right? Such that through drop down, we select one of them and then plot it on the graph. Cool. Let me just comment it again. On Streamlit, we call drop down as select box. So yeah, I've just written this line, which is technical indicator is equal to st.selectbox tech indicator, and then options is equal to all the options that would be in list, which is the list of the indicators, right? Let me just save it. Let's go back here, rerun. So we've got this like this. So you can see the entire list of all different technical indicators are here. So SMA, we have got simple moving average, EMA, exponential moving average, and so on. Now we have to extract information of these technical indicators. So method is equal to the technical indicator that we are picking, such as in this case, previously I selected SMA, right? Simple moving average. So SMA is basically the method. Now there's a way in order to use this method and then extract information is that is through get attr, right? Here I just need to provide the object, which is TA, and the method, which is this one, right? Now it should be provided with the low, close, high, open, and volume data, and we have seen that all of the those data is are actually here, which is the data low. The data is actually the pricing data that we extracted here. If you see this one, right? So low, close, high, open, and volume. Let's just write it st.write and let's see if it works. Rerun. Exactly, it is working actually. So SMA is this one. If I just write EMA, we have got EMA. If I just write a rune, we should get 3-4 exactly, three different columns and so on. And you can see all the data is also present over here. Perfect. So it's better to explicitly write pd.dataframe, although it was already in data frame, just to be on a safer side, right? And then indicator is equal to this one. Perfect, right? Now here we should have close as well, which is close price as well, the last price or the adjusted price in the end, then only it can be actually plotted on the chart. So for that, it's basically indicator close is equal to data and then close. Let's just write again, which is st dot write indicator, control s. Let's go here, rerun. We have got the close price as well. Now similar to the graph that we plotted above, which is here, which is px dot line, I'm using the same concept here to plot indicator, which has the close price as well. st.plotly chart, and then the this one that I actually created for indicators, and in the end, let me just put it over here. That is, we get the data in the end after we get the plot. We save it. Let's go back here, rerun it. You can see the chart is in front of you, and we have got the data as well. So if I change it, say SMA, we get the SMA graph automatically. If it's EMA, we get it the EMA as well. VWAP, it is also here, and a rune. ADX is here. The B bands, which is Bollinger bands, is also here. So which actually you can just go and select this particular area, and you can see the entire analysis of this particular region and so on. And if you have any questions, please write it on the comment section. If you're still watching this video, please guys, I deserve one like. Just click on that one like button. It's free of cost for you guys, but it's very, very important for me. And also if you subscribe to my YouTube channel, that would be very, very helpful. Very important point, guys, some of you guys would know that I share my Google Drive access with this community, and I will have this code as well saved in the Google Drive. And not only this code, there are many more codes saved in that Google Drive, like my trading bot, some of the projects that I actually bid in last a few years. In order to get an access of my Google Drive, you just need to click on my, I would say, access to my Google Drive button, and then just follow some steps. It's like 1/3 a cost of coffee that a month. That would be the entire cost of my Google Drive. Also guys, if you're interested to join my exclusive Patreon community, then definitely guys, you should check it out. The link is in the description box, and in through the Patreon exclusive community, I'm in touch with all of them personally through WhatsApp and through one-on-one and group meetings, and we have multiple conversations on different topics. Recently, actually, I'm starting another type of meeting called Connecting Dots, where we will be trying to connect the knowledge that we guys have, and we'll try to help each other over there. The link is in the description box. Thank you so much guys for watching this video till the end. You can click here to subscribe to my YouTube channel, and over there you'll see the entire playlist of Streamlit from the beginning till the end. And down there you can actually see the Pandas TA library, where you will understand each and everything about Pandas TA library. So guys, keep learning, keep exploring, and I'll see you very, very soon. Peace.